Today we will start with matrices and determinants. Okay. So last class I have done quadratic equation and I have given you cubic equation theory also. We are now going to do problems on that. Problems they may ask you on quadratic only. Okay. So now this is the last part of your first unit, matrices and determinants. Okay. So I will be writing the theory over here. Just you can have a look. Okay. So I will define matrices. A matrix. A matrix. A matrix is a rectangular. A matrix is a rectangular array. Array of numbers.
Can you
मैट्रिक्स ऑफ ऑर्डर m into n, it is said to be matrix of order m into n. The matrices are usually denoted by capital letters. The matrices are usually denoted by capital letters. Are denoted by capital letters A comma B comma C dot dot. A comma B comma C dot dot. Okay. In above example, matrix A is of the order, matrix A is of the order, this one is of the order, what it is, usually order is denoted. Is of the order. See, how many rows are there? One row, two row, three rows. One, two columns. Is of the order 3 into 2. Okay. The elements of the matrix are also enclosed. The elements of the matrix. The elements of the matrix are also enclosed. So you understood what is row and what is column. Horizontal lines are rows and vertical lines are columns. Got it? That you have to keep it in mind. Otherwise, the basic things are not known to you, it will become very difficult. Again, I am repeating, the horizontal lines are called rows and vertical lines are called columns. Okay? In general, now we will write in general, in general aij, aij is an element, is an element, is an element like, is an element like in the what ith row, in the ith row and jth column. So here I stand for row and j stand for column, and lying in the ith row and jth column. Okay, the matrix is briefly denoted by the matrix is briefly denoted by AIJ, is briefly denoted by in square bracket AIJ, okay, square bracket AIJ, where I is equal to 1, 2, 3, dot 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 PM, and J is equal to 1, 2, 3, dot dot dot.
Having only
one row, a matrix having only one row, having only one row is called a row matrix. Is called a row matrix. Is called a row matrix. For example, 1, 2, 3. For example, 1, 2, 3. Now listen, I will write the order of this matrix also. What it is? 1, 2, 3 is one row. Okay? 1. Multiplied by 1 column, second one is second column, third element is third column. It is 1 into 3. It is 1 into 3. Okay? The second one is column matrix. Column matrix. Column matrix is what? A matrix having only one column, is called column matrix. Is called column matrix. Okay. For example, you can write 1, 2, 3, one column. So again, how many rows are there? One row, two row, three rows into one column. Only one vertical line is there, huh? That's why it is one column. Okay. Next, third one is zero or null matrix. Zero, third one. Zero or null matrix. Zero or null matrix. A matrix in which all the elements are zero. A matrix in which all the elements are zero. A matrix in which all the elements are zero is called a zero or null matrix. And is denoted by O. So for example, O is equal to order will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So this order will be on 1 row, 2 row and column 1, 2, 3. It is 2 by 2. Okay? So this is 0 or null matrix. Now the fourth one comes square matrix. Square matrix. Fourth one, square matrix. Square matrix. Square matrix. Okay? The matrix in which the number of rows, a matrix in which the number of rows is equal to the number of columns is equal to the number of columns is called a square matrix. Okay? Is called a square matrix. Is called one column, two columns, 2 by 2. So here number of rows and columns are equal. It is of order 2 by 2. Next, one row, two row, three rows, three cross. One column, second column, third column. So second example is what? Number of rows and columns are equal to 3. So it is of order 3 by 3. Okay? That is the square matrix. Now after square matrix, we will denote diagonal elements. Then I will write the fifth one. Okay? Now fourth is over. Here only I have mentioned diagonal elements. Diagonal elements, diagonal D, I, G, O, N, A, L, G, O, N, A, L, diagonal elements. In a square matrix, the diagonal, in a square matrix, in a square matrix, the diagonal from left to right, the diagonal, the diagonal from left to right, the diagonal from left to right is called the principal diagonal, is called the principal diagonal, is called the principal diagonal. Okay, it's called the principal diagonal. That is what? In a square matrix, the diagonal from left to right is called principal diagonal. For example, here I have written 1, 2, 3, 4. So from my left is what? 1 is there. Okay, from left to right we have 1. Then second row I come, right is 4. So 1, 4 is a diagonal element. Got it? So here also it is 1, 5, 9. 1, 5, 9 is a diagonal element. Okay, that is how it is. Then we'll write down the elements lying around principal diagonal. The elements lying along the principal diagonal, are called the diagonal elements. Obviously, the other elements are called the hind order elements. Obviously, the other elements are called the non-diagonal elements. Let A is equal to A11, A12, A13, okay, A21, A22, A23. A31, A32, A33. Okay, I will tell you. Let A is equal to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Okay, now in this, which are the actual elements? What the definition is saying in a square matrix? This is a square matrix of order 1, 3 by 3, 1 row, 2 row, 3 rows, 1 column, 2nd column, 3rd column, that is 3 by 3 matrix. It is a square matrix. What does it say in a square matrix? The diagonal from left to right. If I am facing the board from left right, it is left to right. So, this is one element in the first row, left side. Then from left to right, I am moving. In second row, I will go here, 822. Again, in the third row, I am going to 832. So, I am going from left to right. It is called the principal diagonal. This is the principal diagonal. A11, A22, A33. It is called as principal diagonal. You are going from left to right. Okay. Here, A11, A22, and A33. Okay. Are the diagonal elements? Are the diagonal elements? Are the diagonal elements are the diagonal elements and A12, A13, A21, A23, A31 and A32 are called the non-diagonal elements. Okay? I hope you have understood which are the diagonal elements. Okay? Now, fifth one is diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix. So, sometimes they will ask in the exam, define diagonal matrix for 2 marks. A square matrix in which a square matrix in which all the non-diagonal elements are equal to 0. All the non-diagonal elements are equal to 0. A square matrix in which all the non-diagonal elements are equal to 0 is said to be a diagonal matrix. Is said to be a diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix. Okay, for example here, what is saying here? A00, B0, sorry, 0B, 0, 0, 0, C. That is what it is saying, huh? A square matrix in which all the non-diagonal elements are equal to 0. These are all non-diagonal elements. Equal to 0 is said to be a diagonal matrix. So, is said to be a diagonal matrix. That is, ABC is the diagonal element. ABC is the diagonal. Okay. Next, we'll define scalar and unit matrix. I will rub the board on this side. और सिक्स्थ वन स्केलर मैट्रिक्स। स्केलर मैट्रिक्स, ओके। स्केलर मैट्रिक्स इज व्हाट? अ डायगोनल मैट्रिक्स इन विच ऑल द डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स आर इक्वल। अ डायगोनल मैट्रिक्स, अ डायगोनल मैट्रिक्स, अ डायगोनल मैट्रिक्स इन विच ऑल डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स आर इक्वल। ऑल डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स आर इक्वल। A diagonal matrix in which all the diagonal elements are equal is called a scalar matrix. Is called a scalar matrix. Is called a scalar matrix. If you want example, an example will be what? For example. A diagonal matrix in which all the diagonal elements are equal. Here all are equal, na? All are A. All are A. Diagonal elements all are A. Okay. Next one is unit matrix. Unit matrix. Unit matrix. Unit matrix is what? A scalar matrix in which a scalar matrix in which all the diagonal elements are equal to unity. Unit matrix. Okay. So for example, here what happens? 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So this is of order 3 by 3. Okay. If you want 2 by 2, then you want 1 0 0 1. 2 by 2. This is 2. So what is saying? A scalar matrix. Which here in scalar matrix, what it was, all the diagonal elements are equal. Here also it is equal, but equal to unity. It should be 1. It should not be 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3 and all. It should be 1. Equal to unity. Then it is called a unit matrix. Got it? So next is symmetric matrix. Next one is symmetric matrix. Symmetric. Yes, why? Symmetric. Next one is symmetric matrix. Okay, a square matrix. A square matrix. a square matrix A is equal to Aij. A square matrix A is equal to Aij of order m. Of order m is said to be symmetric. Is said to be. Is said to be symmetric. Is said to be symmetric if Aij is equal to Aji. Is said to be symmetric if Aij is equal to Aji for all I, comma j. For all I, comma j. Aij is equal to Aji. Okay. Next one is skew symmetric matrix. Skew. Skew symmetric matrix. Skew symmetric matrix. A square matrix A. A square matrix A is equal to Aij. A square matrix A is equal to Aij of order n. Of order n is said to be. Is said to be skew symmetric. Is said to be skew symmetric if Aij is equal to minus Aji. Okay, is said to be skew symmetric if Aij is equal to minus Aji for all I, comma j. For all I, comma j. Okay, so these are the types of matrices. There are 9 types. Okay, usually they are scalar, unit, or diagonal matrix. But you should be ready with all the definitions. Okay, next we will go with algebra of matrices. Okay, have a look. Algebra of matrices. Algebra of matrices. Algebra of matrices. Okay, first one is equality of matrices. Equality of matrices. Equality of matrices. Okay, that is what two matrices A and B of the same order are said to be equal if their corresponding elements are equal. Okay, two matrices A and B of the same order. Two matrices. Two matrices A and B. Two matrices. Two matrices A and B of the same order of same order of the same order are equal, are said to be equal, are said to be, are said to be equal if the corresponding elements are equal, if they are corresponding, if they are corresponding elements, if their corresponding elements are equal. Okay, two matrices A and B of the same order are said to be equal if their corresponding elements are equal. If A is equal to, if A is equal to bracket A I J and B is equal to B I J. Okay, where I is equal to what will be 1 2 3 M. Where I is equal to 1 2 3 dot 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 M and J will be 1 2 3 dot 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 N. Okay. Then A equal to B, then A equal to B if and only if A I J is equal to B I. A equal to, see, A equal to B if and only if A I J is equal to B I. That is what corresponding elements of both the matrices should be equal. And before that, first condition is what both the matrices of should be of same order. If they are of different order, you can't make it equal. Got it? They should be of same order. Next one is scalar multiplication. Scalar multiplication. Scalar multiplication. Okay. If A is a matrix, if A is a matrix, if A is a matrix and K any scalar, and K any scalar, if A is a matrix and K any scalar, okay, any scalar, then K A is a matrix, then KA is a matrix, then KA is a matrix obtained, is a matrix obtained, is a matrix obtained by multiplying every element of A, by multiplying every element of A, every element of A by multiplying every element of A by K. Okay, by K. If A is equal to Aij, okay, then K A is what? Will be K Ai inside. Means to each element in that K will be multiplied. That scalar quantity K will be multiplied to each element. I'll show you for example. For example, A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay? Then 2a will be what? 2a will be what? This 2 is a scalar. It will be multiplied to each element. 2 1 is a 2. 2 2 is a 4. 2 3 is a 6. 2 4 is a 8. 2 5 is a 10. 2 6 is a 12. That is all. You got it? Scalar multiplication means there are two types of multiplication. One is scalar, now it is over. Another is two matrix will be given, you have to multiply. Okay, that I will tell you later. So this is scalar multiplication. After that we have addition and subtraction of matrices. Both together I will write. Third one, addition or subtraction. Addition or subtraction of matrices. Subtraction or both together I write it in one instead of giving separately. Okay. Addition or subtraction of matrices. Okay. If A and B are matrices of the same order, if A and B are the matrices of the same order, of the same, if A and B are the matrices of the same order, then P plus or minus B. Why am I writing a plus or minus B? Because I am doing both at the same. If it is addition, you write A plus B. If it is subtraction, you write B minus B. Okay? Of the same order, then A plus or minus B is defined to be, is defined to be a matrix, is defined to be a matrix, to be a matrix obtained by adding, obtained by adding, or is that the plus or minus, by, is obtained by adding or subtracting the corresponding elements of A and B. The corresponding elements of A and B. Okay? If A and B are the matrices of same order, then A plus or minus B is defined to be a matrix obtained by adding or subtracting the corresponding elements of A and B. I'll show you one example here.
Plus or minus B is defined to be a matrix
matrix obtained by adding or subtracting the corresponding elements of A and B. Corresponding means what? Here 2 plus 1 corresponding. Then 4 plus 3 corresponding. Got it? 7 plus 5. Then 8 plus 4. Then 9 plus 7 corresponding elements. 10 plus 8. So what you get? 2 plus 1, 3. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus 5, 12. 8 plus 4, 12. 9 plus 7, 16. 18. This much you got it? Okay. Now same way, we will do subtraction. A minus B is what? 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1. 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3. 7 minus 5. Then 8 minus 4. 9 minus 7. 10 minus 8. 10 minus 8. This will be what? 2 minus 1 is 1. 4 minus 3 is 1. 7 minus 5 is 2. 8 minus 4 is 4. 9 minus 7 is 2. 10 minus 8 is 2. This way you get it. Okay? I hope you have understood addition and subtraction. Now comes the multiplication. Again, I told you, now. Once scalar multiplication is over, now multiplication of matrices. So that you have to be very careful. Multiplication of matrices. Okay? That will